Fire. Is anybody listening? The city's on fire. The town is burning down. But there's no water.
The essence of my music is and always will be a love. Because even the fact that I play music, I play music out of love. That's where everything comes from, because I really love music and I feel really dedicated to music. So it already comes from that place, you know, where there's just love and everything is positive. But then I kind of realized that music is as well a very powerful weapon, you know, to use, because I think music is a way to touch people and to bring awareness. And it's a good way to bring awareness, you know. It's probably, I would say, one of the greatest ways, you know, to talk about certain things and maybe things that others won't necessarily talk about, even in the news sometimes, you know. All this, I think with music you can really communicate. It's a great way to communicate. My music is can be very personal, but even when it's very personal, it is still not personal. You know what I mean? It's like, it's personal. It's my story, but my story can become your story, because maybe we share more than we think we do, you know? Maybe we share the same kind of story. I know very little about politics, but I know right from wrong, and I think there's a lot of crazy stuff going on at the moment. When you look at Egypt and you know, you look at Syria and everything, it's I don't know, too much stuff going on that shouldn't be going on. And I think we can probably do more than we think we can do, you know. It's like we all, when we watch the news, we're far away from this, but at the end of the day we're not that far away, because tomorrow the same thing can happen to us, you know. And I believe we should all be one, and we should all be there for each other. And so in my record I do talk about things that I believe should be the concern of everybody. Music is a beautiful thing, and you can sing a thousands of love songs, and I love songs. My favorite songs are love songs, you know. I'm a very corny kind of person, totally romantic and everything, you know. I love love songs, but I think it's important as well to talk about what's actually going on, you know. I think that's my duty, you know. That's how I feel.
8 million citizens, nobody's really listening, nobody's really watching. 8 million ignorant, 80,000 teachers, way too many preachers. A thousands of leaders, but nobody leads us. 3 million beggars, 4 million pleasers. We are the world, but they don't really need us. Ghetto got no funds, ghetto ain't no fun. Ghetto kids got guns, ghetto got no one. Ghetto got no funds, ghetto ain't no fun. Ghetto kids got guns, cause they got no one.
One love pour mes soldats, one love pour mes petites sœurs. Prise en otage avec une bombe à la place du cœur.
When you are like when you're 20 years old, your walk will be different from when you're 30 years old, and when you're 40 you're going to walk totally different again. And you know, like you change your pace, you change your comfort, you know. A lot of things they change, and due to the confidence you gain. And I think maybe the big change is it's maturity, you know. I'm more mature now, and I think it's quite complete now, because you will find every color, maybe even more than on the first, second, and third record. Now I can say it's complete, because I'm rapping again, as an example, which is a part of me, but which I put aside. But now I did it, and I can say maybe I didn't even do it because I was worried. I think it's a wrong thing. It's wrong to think about what the others are gonna think about you, you know. As long as you're honest, as long as you're sincere, you can do whatever you want to. Hip-hop has always been a big part of my musical culture, because before I used to be a singer and a guitarist, I was a rapper. So most of the people, they don't know this, because they only know Ayo playing the guitar and singing songs. But before I used to really write songs on the guitar and sing those songs, I was rapping. So for me, it's like going back to my roots, kind of, you know. And I never really, I don't know, I think when I picked up the guitar, and I, because I'm self-taught, so when I started playing the guitar and I started singing my songs, I forgot about hip-hop. No, I didn't forget about hip-hop, I forgot about rapping. I didn't feel like I can play the guitar and rap, you know. I love Lauryn Hill, you know. I cannot say I don't, because, you know, sometimes people, they would be like, oh, hey, we can hear a bit of Lauryn Hill going on there or something. And I could never say, oh, that's not possible, because, yes, she did inspire me, you know. And when I used to rap, the Fugees just came out with their record. And you know, this is always the way it is. I think when you start music, you always have somebody to, you know, somebody who really inspires you to the point where you really strive to be not like them, but you strive to create something that is just like what they created, or maybe better, or maybe, you know, you just want to walk or move towards the same direction, you know. I like Nas as a rapper, and Nas was always my favorite rapper. I love Talib Kweli, you know, all this kind of, this is more like I'm very old school in terms of hip hop. As an example, I'm very old school. I'm not like, I don't know, all this new. I mean, I like Odd Future, Tyler the Creator. I have to say that because my son loves Tyler the Creator. So if I don't mention him, he's gonna be like, why didn't you say Tyler the Creator? I think he's really, really good. Earl Sweatshirt, all this, you know. I think they have good, because these guys, to me, they're actually even more, that it's like new school, but they still, to me, they still have this, it's like they still have this old school soul, kind of, you know. And I like that. I always look for the stuff that has a bit of the leftovers of the 90s and the 80s in it, you know, kind of. Is anybody listening? The city's on fire. A town is burning down, but there's no water. Is anybody listening? The city's on fire.
Mais je vous aime quand même. On m'a appris à trahir, mais je vous relève quand même. Je ne suis pas venu seul, viens ma soeur que je t'emmène. Je n'ai que ma grande gueule, pas de gun, que des emmerdes. Viens que je t'emmène, viens que je t'enlève. Viens que je te sauve, que je te cause, que je t'engraine. Graine de colère, mon ghetto est sous pression. Jour de tonnerre, peu de réponses, trop de questions. Nous terre par l'oppression, qu'on tombe de sommeil. Comment nous faire de l'ombre, on est les enfants du soleil.
One of the artists who really inspired me the most is really, I would say, Michael Jackson. Because when I was a child, for me, Michael Jackson was like, I don't know, he was like a superhero to me, you know. He was just so different and so special and so, I don't know, just there was nothing like that, you know. And maybe there will never be anybody like him. Certainly, I was a child and I used to dance to his music, and I had a big afro. And when I looked at the Jackson 5, I don't know, you know, he had a big afro and all this, I felt like, I kind of could relate to Michael. I mean, even at times where he didn't have an afro anymore and he became a bit lighter, you know, Michael to me was like he's the ultimate, you know. It can't get any better than Michael Jackson. To me, there's nothing better than Michael Jackson. But then, of course, my other influences were probably like, I really like Nina Simone. I like Bob Marley. I like Peter Tosh. I love Donny Hathaway, Stevie Wonder, everything, pretty much everything that's Motown, Stax, or Atlantic Record, or even Island Record, you know. Everything that had, I would say, an authentic kind of sound, you know, I would say it inspired me. Everything that was really real, and in a way, yeah. This is my first record on Motown, and it was always a dream to have just the logo on my record, you know, to have a Motown record. I mean, that I to me, it's already, just that already is like, it's a great success to me, you know, because when I was a child and I looked at my dad's records, you know, because he had a great record collection, because he used to be DJ in the 70s, and I was born in the 80s, but all these records are from the 60s and 70s, and each time I would pick a record that had a Motown sticker on it, you know, it was always a good record. So it's almost like you buy a Motown record, you know it's a great record. But now I can't say this anymore, because it's gonna be like, oh my God, she's so arrogant.
Nobody's listening to the sounds of the street, the clamor, the violence, the sirens, the heat. 5 million scared, 3 out of 5 million desperate. 1 million hurt, yeah. Thousands arrested. Yeah.
Allume ton esprit, sors de leurs griffes. Relève ton estime, sors de leurs chiffres. J'enchaîne les coups de gueule. Mais on ne libère pas un peuple se libère tout seul. Fire.
The city's on fire. The town is burning down. There ain't no sounds of silence. Tell me who's gonna help us now.
Je vous aime, yeah.
Nobody's listening.
Personne.
8 million people crying and looking for shelter.
Yeah.
But they got nowhere to go.
For me, France is like a. It's, you know, my relation. I mean, the feeling that I have for this country already is, I feel like I'm adopted by this country, you know, because the first time people have ever really paid real attention to my lyrics, to my music, to my story, was actually here, you know, and I truly appreciate the fact that. They have a great, you know, I don't know how to say this, but people here, they seem to have great appreciation for real music, you know. You can come with just one tool and that would be, let it be the guitar and play something where maybe others would say, oh, but, you know, it needs a bit more of, there's no beat, there's no this, there's no that. Or, you know, people, they always look for something. They always want more than, you know, what they can find. And, I think here in France, people they like simplicity. The way they listen to me and the love they gave me and how you know what, they were so welcoming and everything. When you're not used to this, it's crazy, you know. When you're not used to it at all. I was not used to that, you know. And so when Nagi. When Nagi played my music, I wasn't even, I mean, my record wasn't out and everything. And just that, to me, is unheard of, you know? They listen to an artist who has no name, you know? And this, to me, it's so touching that France, for me, it's like, when I play in Paris, it's like playing at home, you know? More than when I play in Germany. When I play in Paris, I feel home. J'ai des amours, mon pays, Paris. You know, it's the same for me. It's the same for me.
Is anybody listening? The city's on fire.
Maybe, who knows, maybe one day I will do a rap record. MC Ayo.